In 1982, I became a member of the Interior and Insular Affairs Committee, which has direct jurisdiction over Indian matters. And I was Michigan's only representative on that. So Arnold Somich then began to really come to Washington. There was about $7 million in settlement. It was all set aside, but people couldn't agree on how to distribute that money. And some, of course, and there's always, you know, going to be differences. You are a sovereign nation, and you have voters, right? And you have people who will differ. And some wanted a distribution kind of immediately to everybody. Arnold felt that basically he wanted some money so you could pull yourselves out of the poverty that you were in. So he finally, and he said, don't even sign the bill, co-sponsor the bill, because it calls for immediate distribution. We have to have some money so we can have economic development. So he and I worked out a compromise. For the older people, the elders, we said we'll have some immediate distribution because they might not live to see this economic development. But the bulk of it then, so we distributed some to the elders, the bulk we kept for economic development. And it really worked. And Arnold, I tell you, he educated me. He was kind, generous, and very, very intelligent. And we wrote a better bill. It took us a little over a year because there was that division, even within the Congress, even with the members, the Michigan members. Some said, no, let's distribute it. It's individuals' money. And Arnold said, well, we can give individuals who are older the money, but let's keep some of the money for ourselves. He was a real visionary. So we came upon that compromise. And that became the seed corn for many things for this tribe.